Welcome back to Buildsum, and in this video we're going to keep going with our long section. And you'll remember in the last video we put in our surface RLs and we actually plotted them onto our graph to give us a representation of the natural surface of the ground. So now we're going to have a look at our trench. So just got to do a couple of side calculations to do that, so we'll jump over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say that at point one, we're going to have an invert level of 600 mil. So an invert level is the level or the distance from the top of the ground to the bottom of the pipe. And you can see there, the inside bottom of the pipe. So 600 mil to there. And then we're going to allow another 150 mil for the thickness of the pipe plus the sand. All right, because when we excavate and they put the pipe in, they're going to put a bed of sand on the bottom, and we want the actual level to the pipe. So the pipe, if we slope the pipe, it'll actually flow. Okay, so that gives us a total depth of our trench of 750 mil. Now the trench is going to fall. I mentioned that at the start, and we're going to say it's going to have a grade of 1.5%, or a slope of 1.5%. Okay, so to work out, that's fine. So if we divide 1.5 by 100, that tells us that it will fall or rise 0.015 meters or 15 mil every meter that it runs. So over the length of our trench, which is 50 meters long, it's actually going to rise or fall 750 mil. Okay, however, our readings are 5 meters apart, so we need to know that also. So if we times our 0.015 by 5, that tells us that every 5 meters, our trench rises or falls 0.075 meters or 75 mil. So with that information, we can go back to our graph and we can actually plot in the trench on our graph or our long section. So we'll jump back into here. I'll just get us up to where we were. Plot in our surface RL. Okay, so we know at point one, the depth of our trench is 750 millimeters. So we can write that in there as the depth of our trench. Then what we do is we take the 750 mil off our surface RL, and that will give us a design level or a design RL for point one. So the bottom of the trench at point one will have an RL of 29.462. Now, remembering I said that for every 5 meters, that trench is going to fall, in this case, it's going to fall 75 millimeters. So from this RL here, we take off 75 millimeters and we'll get 29.387. Take off another 75 millimeters, we get 29.312, and we keep taking our 75 mil off that until we get to our last figure. Okay, and if you want to do a quick check, if you take 28.712 away from 29.462, you should get a difference of 750 mil. Okay, and that looks pretty good just looking at it. So that means that our trench is falling 750 mil over the total survey. So now what we do is to get the depth of our trench at each of these points, because obviously our ground's going up and down, whereas our trench is just falling at a constant rate. What we do is we take the surface RL and minus that from the design level, and that will give us the depth of the trench at each of these points. So 30.378 minus 29.387 will give us a difference of 991 millimeters. 30.429 minus 29.312 gives us a meter of 1 meter 117, and we just keep going along and we take off those measurements. Okay, so then we have the height of our trench, which we will need when we go to work out the area and the volume for each of those points. So that's pretty much the graph done. The next last little step is just to actually plot the trench onto our long section. So there's a couple of ways you can do this. Similar to what we did before, you can plot the 29.462. You can plot that up, or if you wanted to, you could scale the depth down, the 750. You could scale that down from the actual the trench mark on your graph. But either way, you're going to put a point on your graph that represents where the trench is. And with the trench, because it's straight and constant, we don't need to plot every point. We can just plot the first point and the last point, and then we can actually just draw a line in between. So here, our measurement's 28.712. So it's going to be, you know, sort of just up around here somewhere. So put that in there. And then we're going to draw a line in between those two to represent our trench. Okay, and then if you want to do a bit of a check, you can have a look. So here, 29.162, so it's just above the 29, so that's in about the right spot. That's a little bit lower. Yep, so that bottom line there represents the bottom of the trench. So now we have a long section graph showing our natural surface of our ground and the bottom of our trench with the fall built in. We know how deep the trench is at each of those points that we took a reading, and we know what the RL is. So the next step then, and in the next video, I will show you how to calculate the area of this trench, and then of course from the area we can work out volume. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.